Hello everybody, welcome to our video tutorials. In this video, we will show you a feature in our easygen 3000XT controllers called PV load reduction. Photovoltaic sources have become more popular in the recent times. In a lot of applications, we can run parallel the synchronous generator to the photovoltaic sources, and in some cases, it makes absolute sense, because we have a lot of sun available. The advantage of running a generator parallel to PV inverter is that we save fuel. However, there is a challenge. You feed the load from your photovoltaic installation and you are running on an island. Then you can bring your synchronous generator in a minimum load and maybe even reverse power. This is not acceptable, and because of that, we introduced into the easygen XT new function, called PV load reduction. By default, we always operate solar at the maximum to ensure maximum penetration of renewable in the energy mix and derate only when the generator crosses its minimum configurable load set point. This ensures that the generator and PV source are working together in harmony without driving generator to the reverse power while ensuring maximum solar intake. So, we are looking all the time at our generator load, and if our generator load comes under a configurable limit, we begin to reduce the power of the PV inverter. And of course the PV inverter needs some inputs. We can send the inputs via analog outputs, we can use digital outputs as well, or we can use a functionality called Modbus Master to write required set point to the inverter. PV load reference is the output of our easygen going into inverter. So, for example, in this screenshot, we have minimal load of 30%. That means we observe our load. And if our load goes below this 30%, we start sending the load reduction signal, and we do that with regulation here. The advantage of regulation approach is that we do not need power measurement from the inverter, so this PV load reference is regulated through PID. We also have possibility to decouple the PV in critical situations, therefore we have photovoltaic disconnect command here. Here we can see how we influence the inverter, three digital outputs, analog output, voltage or current, or Modbus Master command. Let us see how this works in our simulation. We have a 200 kilowatts generator and photovoltaic installation, with peak solar capacity 100 kilowatts. The two energy sources are supplying a load of 100 kilowatts, currently in island operation. Now, in Toolkit we will go to Parameter, Configure Application, Configure Controller, Miscellaneous. Here we have PV load reference parameters. As you can see, the PV regulation is turned on, and it is active when the main circuit breaker is open, meaning we are on an island. The minimum load on the generator is set to 30%, and right now, we have more than that, so the signal to PV inverter is that we want all the power available. Now, let's try to decrease our load, so the generator will not have 30% of its load. As we fell below 30%, the regulation starts to decrease the PV power, so we are sending the lowest point to the inverter, because we do not want full power from PV right now. As we can see, the digital set point jumps to 60%, where the analog set point decreases to reach the proper value. Now, the load goes back to higher value, and we are above our minimal power limit in generator. This is all for today. Make sure you check our other video tutorials.